This CLD success package video covers sequencer applications. My name is Mark Ramsdale. I'll be your host. Exercises 9 and 10 use a simple state machine to create a sequencer. We see that the case structure contains the model logic that determines the next case to be called. This is based on value of the auto reset and the time has elapsed. Each state can call the next state, and in state 3 we proceed back to state 1. This is a continuous loop through the states. The steps are completely determined by the model logic, and there's no interaction to change these other than changing the auto reset. Exercise 10 uses the same solution, however, there is one additional state. It is called when the application starts. This state is a type of initialization. It reads the file data, transforms the file data, and this state, this case, immediately proceeds to run step number 1. At this point, the application is the same as the previous application. Each of the steps can decide to call itself or to call the next state in order. The difference here is that the file data resides in this shift register, and depending on the state or the case, the file data is pushed out to the indicators and to the data line for the time target. Exercise 13 uses an event-driven state machine create a sequencer. After initialization, the application proceeds to idle, where in a timeout state, the application steps to the process. After the process is completed, the application steps back to idle. This continues throughout the operation of the application. However, there is a user interface event. It can create a new series of steps. If the user chooses to stop the flow, the stop flow case is called. The stop flow decides to either return to itself or to send the application to idle, based on, finally, the flow rate becoming 0. Application 14 is a state machine that loads time-elapsed values from a file and steps through a run state for the duration of a time-elapsed value and continues this process until all the time-elapsed values have been used and returns to idle. The application uses an array to hold a series of steps. The enums are loaded into the array, and the application will step through all of the cases in order as they're loaded into the array. The application will wait in idle, looking for the front panel activity. Once the start button is pressed, the series of steps will be loaded into the array. We'd have to look at the initialization state to see these steps being added. There is a small piece of model logic here so that if the timer is in pause, the application will now start the initialization. The initialization phase reads the file data, starts the timer. Timer proceeds to check time after performing its action of actually starting the timer. And the check time will send the application through the run state and the idle state until the time has elapsed, at which case it will change the time looking for the next time. The run state performs its action. In this model, is just to spend time, and it sends the application back to check time. In this way, the array is loaded with states. The application can step through these states based on the decision of the model logic. There is some front panel interaction. There is only pause, stop, start, and cancel. In the CLD exam, it is important to get your model so that it can start performing the basic steps. Then, once this is up and running, start to add more of the detail of the business model. Perhaps there are additional steps or other front panel activities that might modify the current sequence of steps that is occurring. Exercise 12 is a state machine that sequences steps based on a file. The file loads time targets, the amount of time that the application will spend in a certain state, and it loads state data that is displayed on the front panel. The application uses the LabVIEW queue sub-VIs to manage a queue. This is very similar to the array. After initialization, the application is stepped to idle, where, with no activity occurring, it continues to step through the idle case. Once the start button has run, we will head off and we will see that the states are loaded into the queue to allow the application to step through different cases. The file is opened. All of the data is pulled out, which includes the names of the cases that will be run in the step order. Here we see that the state names and the state data is loaded into the queue. For this application, first we must set the time. Then we proceed to one of the called states, either run state 1 or run state 2. The model here is to continue returning to this run state until the time has elapsed. To do that, we can simply reload the same state call, the same case call, at the front of the queue. All of the other commands loaded from the file are still in the queue and they're waiting. However, until the time elapses, we continue to run this state and display any state data. It's the same situation for run state 2. As a sequencer, this application uses the queue to load up the different cases that the application will step through. Some of the steps that are taken depend on the model logic. Mainly in this application, this simple example, has time elapsed. The state data, certainly in the CLD exam, could play a role in determining which steps are added or removed from the sequence. In the CLD exam, part of the strategy is to get your step machine working, to get a first initial set of sequences that it can be stepped through. For example, starting, processing data, and stopping. Then proceed to implement more of the functionality, some of the state data, how does that change. Exercise 11 uses the producer-consumer as a state machine to step through or to sequence the different cases. We see that there are many steps available. The model logic will call some of the steps, and the user interaction will call some of the steps. This is very typical in the CLD. The CLD can use a combination of file-loaded sequences and user interface activities that create sequences. The CLD exam will be based on a sequencing model. There will be multiple steps. These steps can come from a variety of sources. They are defined by the model. They can be loaded from a file. Steps can be added or changed due to the user interface interactions. Timing steps may be required. Queues can be an important part of a sequencer. For the CLD exam, the overall strategy is to create a sequencing or stepping state machine. We have discussed the overall strategy. Part of this is to create a sequencer that can go through a basic set of steps, and then to add functionality based on the model requirements.